You're watching WTAE Channel 4, now in high definition. This is Channel 4 Action News at 5.
They promised to give a free cell phone, free service, free voicemail, even free call waiting, all of it through a government program.
Now, whether this offer you've likely seen on TV is really legit, and if so, who's paying for it? Call for Action reporter Aaron Sakin is here with some answers that will make you either very happy or very angry.
Could go either way. Now, our Call for Action office has been getting a ton of phone calls about this offer. You know, as good consumers, we should be skeptical when we hear something is free. So we did some digging, and some folks were a bit, well, surprised by what we discovered.
If I have an emergency outside my home, how do I call for help?
The company is called SafeLink Wireless, and in its TV commercials offers some of you with low incomes a free cell phone with free service.
There's always a catch.
Exactly. Nothing's really free.
Is this legitimate?
Yes, it's highly legitimate. It's coming out of a fund set aside by the Federal Communication Commission to service rural areas, under-supported people.
Originally designed to provide basic emergency home phone service, the fund recently expanded to offer low-income households free cell phone usage.
It shifted because the way people use telephones have shifted.
A prepaid cell phone company called TrackPhone administers the program. Eligible customers get a phone and 42 unrestricted free monthly minutes with the option of buying more. Thing is, the government's not paying for it. We are. You know that extra universal service fund fee you pay on your home phone bill? That's where the money's coming from.
I think it's a good program to help, especially low-income people that may have children. They go back and forth to school, do after-school activities. You have seniors that get stranded out here.
Maybe if they are people with medical or potential medical emergencies or people with small children, I could almost see it. But just to give low-income people or anyone a cell phone, I don't know. I think that rubs me the wrong way.
Well, if you'd like to contact the FCC to share your opinion of the program, positive and negative, we have its phone number and email address on the consumer page of the PittsburghChannel.com. There you can also find more information about SafeLink, including who specifically is eligible and how to apply. Aaron Sakin, Channel 4 Action News.